although the wasps and the present day types break away, leaving the stage clear for the air show debut of this magnificently restored Wessex HU5, the only Wessex currently flying in the UK, and a machine that during its active service days was stationed for many years here at Yeovilton. In the static display here, also from historic helicopters, you can see their bright yellow ex-Royal Air Force Search and Rescue Whirlwind HAR-10. Well, just as Westland license-built the Sikorsky S-55 as the Whirlwind, so it did the later Sikorsky S-58 as the Wessex. The S-58 was shipped to the UK and re-engined with a single Napier Gazelle engine. The first Westland-built Wessex followed in June 1958. The Wessex was ordered first by the fleet air arm of the Royal Navy as the anti-submarine HAS-1 variant. They began to be delivered in 1960 and entered service the following year. It was the first anti-submarine helicopter for the Royal Navy that was designed for that role from the outset and with gas turbine power. Right from the outset, the Wessex HAS-1 gave Royal Navy and submarine warfare capabilities a huge boost, significantly in the night and all-weather regimes. It had a larger payload and all-round superior performance to the Whirlwind that preceded it. To give way to the further improved HAS-3. By then, the RAF was also operating the Wessex in HC-24. It was a much improved derivative with twin coupled Rolls-Royce Gnome turboshaft engines. It was ordered by the RAF as a general purpose transport, and they operated worldwide in support of British and Allied coalition forces. The RAF Wessex served for many years in Northern Ireland, and they were the last British military aircraft to be stationed in Hong Kong. And that twin gnome configuration is the one we see here on the HU5. In significant numbers during 1982's Falklands campaign, deploying special forces, members of the Special Air Service and the Special Boat Service. They moved men and material around the theatre, but it came at a cost. 9 Wessex were lost in the Falklands, including 6 when the container ship, the Atlantic Conveyor, was sunk in late May 1982 after an attack by Argentinian Navy Super Etendard strike aircraft with their interceptor missile. is with the so-called jungly, the commando helicopter force here with H-48 and H-47 squadron on these jungle inquiries. Foreign transfers to the rescue 7 patrol with 771 squadron. That's the car throw. Then went back to the commander of H-45 squadron in the conflict. Slow down there. To the Royal Navy historic flight, but it ended up being acquired by Andrew Whitehouse for his historic helicopters operation. The restoration in total, Andrew was telling me, lasted in excess of 14,000 hours. It flew again on the 15th of February this year from historic helicopters base near Crewkerne. And his operation has two more Wessex HU5s on strength, plus next project, a Seeking HAR-3 ex-Royal Air Force search and rescue helicopter, and a Seeking HC-4 jungly. They will join the Whirlwind and the Wessex, the two currently airworthy examples. And what a nostalgic sight this is for many of us, particularly in terms of the Wessex search and rescue role, but not just the Royal Navy, but also the RAF, the yellow RAF Wessex HC2s, such a familiar sight in their day around the coasts of the UK. Wessex in 1988. The RAF didn't do so for another 15 years when the type was phased out by last RAF squadron operator. The type also served with